amazing, you know, what I felt when I went to seeking God. You know, that guilt and that shame, that depression, that anxiety, all those things begin to fade away through seeking God. So I learned that the problem's in the pattern. You know, my pattern was so messed up. Like my actions and my behaviors was the patterns that I had. Was totally off the wall. You know, I used to tell my mom and my dad and my kids all the time, I used to tell them, I love you. And, you know, fact of the matter is, my actions and my behaviors didn't show I love anybody but myself, and what I wanted and when I wanted it, and I needed it now. It's pretty much the way my life runs. That was going on the inside when I could say I love you on the outside. You know, the flesh. So there again, you know, it's been spiritual warfare for me. You know, Paul talks about fighting principalities, you know, spiritual wickedness in dark places, and that's exactly what I've been fighting. You know, I've been fighting all these years. And, you know, it didn't really ring a bell until I had picked the book back up and I started to read. You know, God started to show me things. And you know, the solutions to my problems was all in that book. But, you know, He gave me a free will to do what I wanted. And I thought I knew what was best for my life, when in reality, I didn't know anything. I had to live my life for any extent of any kind. My life was completely unmanageable. The people in my life I'd hurt, right down to my kids, neglecting my kids, all because I was so selfish. I needed what I wanted to do what I wanted to do. Is pretty much what it all come out to. That's the bondage of self, you know, selfish. And that's, you know, that's what I found out, you know, through pretty much examining myself and taking my own inventory and figuring out what's wrong with me and why I do the things I do. And that's what it all come back to, driven by fear, a life driven by fear. Not you know, pleasing people thinking I'm not good enough, or all kinds of different forms of fear that run my life, driven by emotions. Because when these thoughts come, you know, my thoughts get the ball rolling. When I think, you know, something's wrong, of course it brings on a low emotional state. It brings on depression, it brings on sadness, it brings on all these emotions that I didn't know what to do with. So my life run on it. So then I would take action on that emotion, and I would usually lash out or hurt somebody or something of that nature. So what I began to do was, you know, through checking this inventory of myself, find out what's going on with me, I learned that all this shame and guilt of all my past actions and all this resentment that I held in upon the inside, I had to get rid of it. So I began confessing these things to a great friend of mine. You know, I began working with him. He's a really, really wise man. I began to confess these things, and he would give me, you know, guidance. You know, the Bible says attaining the wise counsel, and that's what I began to do. I forgot what I thought I knew about life. I put all those things out of my head because really I didn't know nothing about living life. So I cast those things aside, and I began to open my mind for once to something different. So, you know, I began to take suggestions. And, you know, that was the turning point whenever, you know, these people would ask me to do something different. I just done it. Because I didn't have nothing else to lose but my life. And I've been lost everybody. So, you know, it took that desperation for me to get to that spot of wanting to end my life. You know, what the enemy sent to destroy me, God used it to build me and turn my life around. That's exactly what happened. You know, what was sent to destroy my life, God used it in a mighty way. So, you know, let's see. So I came out of treatment that last time, and, you know, I've been sober the 19th, 21 months, by the grace of God. You know, and it's really nothing I do but get up and surrender, man, and, you know, find God. I start my day off with, I know who I am, and I know what I'm capable of. And if I can get that guy out of the way, I can live a different life today through Jesus Christ. And it's all what he does for me. You know, that's grace and mercy. The things I've done, you know, all these, and my life's filled with just horrific stories. I mean, I could go on and on and on, and it really is. And I've hurt people after people after people to the point of what, that's really what it took for me to realize what was going on with me. Because I couldn't see outside of myself. You know, I couldn't see God for me. So I began to pray, God set me free from that. I am my worst enemy. And God began to work in that. God began to show me things. He began to show me where I fall short. And I'm still learning. Like, I couldn't be more grateful for where I'm at today. And he continues to let me learn when I continue to seek him. And I'm able to do so much more today. You know, I could be that father today. I could be that son today. I could be that friend today. Where I couldn't at all, I couldn't do none of those things. And most importantly, I can help somebody else today that's in that spot. Because I know exactly what it's like to be there. And I know the solution's God, you know. They say, they ask me all the time, how you doing? I said, the message is God. Like, that is the message. Without him, I couldn't do anything. You know, left to my own devices, man, I'm a mess. Believe that. But through the power of God, you know, he can give us a spirit of power. And I thank God for that. That's pretty much all I got. But,